Thanksgiving week here.
Mm-hmm. Cannot wait for this year compared to prior ones.
It's a big holiday. You get together with family and friends, and you enjoy some turkey and some stuffing and some green bean casserole.
Oh, so nice. Oh, have some of that cranberry sauce. Try some of grandmother's weird walnut onion olive loaf. She baked it herself. Just pick out the cat treats in it.
I saw a thing on CBS Sunday Morning, which seemed pretty amazing. Guy had a whole cookbook for tater tots, and he makes tater tot stuffing.
That sounds incredible.
Yeah, it's all the seasoning that would go, you know, the sage and the rosemary and the thyme, and maybe a little bit of sausage, some onions, some celery, some carrots, but you make it with tater tots.
Yes, all of that. And don't forward me any of your mason jar Thanksgiving dinner dishwasher meal articles. I ain't doing it. I'm not going to bother drying my hair in a blender. I'm not going to exfoliate the baby in the microwave. I ain't cooking in a dishwasher.
Now you are doing what, Justin, this Thanksgiving?
I'll tell you what I'm doing and cannot wait. I ain't cooking. I'm not traveling. I'm not having anybody over. I am taking the entire family, myself, Mudge, extended boyfriends, girlfriends, little ones, cousins, aunts, and people I've never even met, out to eat.
Oh,
oh
wow.
I can't wait.
Blasphemy.
Oh, God, I can't wait.
I cannot get on board. What would the normal situation be?
Wake up, 5:30 a.m. Gather children, get in car. Get in the car, quit yelling at each other. All right, here we are, we're on our way. Let's get down. Well, watch where you're going, guys. Then you got everybody over at the house. Someone forgot the one thing. Then you got the other family.
Would they come to your house?
We would go. I'm trying to think without doing my usual hyperbole. We would go anywhere from 3 to 5 separate homes over the course of a day.
So for you, it wasn't an issue of cooking and having people at your house and cleaning, because it was never at your house?
One year we did, and we ended up back at my house. We were one of the destinations for everyone. And then when they were there, I mean, they blew into town like locusts. They just ate the paintings off of the wall. They did to my house what Josh's relatives did to his. Like, no, please put that down. That's a limited edition Transformer, please. It was just chaos.
So this was more a logistic thing for you. Like, hey, everybody, one place. Eat, roll out.
Exactly. You see, there's not a lot of, let's just say my life is lacking in tranquility sometimes. At any given time. For example, yesterday, 4:00, just 5 children over. I've got my baby. I got some other stuff I'm trying to do around the house. I got a guy coming over working on the roof. Like, there's not a lot of peace around my place. So I just wanted to streamline the whole damn thing. Plus, there's always some disagreement with who's doing what. I thought you were doing the turkey. No, I thought I was doing the turkey. Oh, wait a minute, you said there was going to be ham. There's not going to be any ham. Wait a minute, 5 people brought a corn casserole, and it's never calm. It's never peaceful. And at the end of it, you're not only just drunk on food and ready to die, there's a tension in the air. There's
That's the holidays. I think you're under the misconception that it's calm and peaceful. Where did you get that idea?
I'm trying to just change course.
Where
I know.
Did that ever come
it's
into
never
play?
Peaceful. I know.
No.
Maybe I'm just pushing against the tide.
You have to see the beauty in the madness.
Oh God. Yeah, so this year I'm gathering up everyone. I said, you know what? I have had a great year. Station's taken good care of me. The murder mystery's done very well. I got something in my throat. Whoa, watch out there. Could you get him a napkin, Michael? And let me give you guys the early Christmas gift of convenience. No one's got to burn themselves on the stove.
So you spearheaded this whole movement.
100%, and everyone was on board. Everyone.
Okay. Yeah, because you're paying.
Hell yeah, daddy's footing the bill, and I don't mind. It's okay.
That's going to be a lot of people. That's going to be like $1,000.
Oh my God.
It's not going to be that much. I'll write down how much it's going to be.
$1,000.
It's not going to be. Well, this is before tip. That's before tip.
So it's going to be close to $1,000.
It's going to be
What the?
That's before tip.
Yeah, it's not going to be 1981. It's going to be that number. That was the time machine answer.
Okay.
I'm spending $1,981.
That's a lot of money.
Yeah, it's going to be 15 people. We're going somewhere very nice. We're going somewhere very fancy pants, but it's also very nice and very warm. And they all seem to be into it, though one person is not. We're starting to get messages from Grandma Mimi.
Yeah, of course. Grandma this Mimi. Is not how you do Thanksgiving, Justin.
I no, it's not.
Didn't
according
want
to
say it, but this is not what you do for Thanksgiving. You're bucking the trend here. You're going against everything that is American.
Yeah.
Out to eat on Thanksgiving.
Taking them to Kenny Rogers Roasters. Yeah, Grandma Mimi ain't happy. And she would cook, and she would have people make a pit stop at her house at one point. And it would be chaos in there. I mean, we'd blow through there like an F5.
Hey, yeah, there's an idea. Tell Mimi not to come, okay? Disinvite Mimi.
Oh,
you two are awful.
She's made it very clear. She's not coming.
Oh. Good. Good for her.
Mimi ain't coming.
I like it. Protest.
Oh, she's laying it on, brother.
You know what? You felt like you were blowing through like an F5, but for her, that was her year.
It's the only time she gets to see it.
Yes.
Yeah.
That's what she lives for, and you're stripping her of that.
Too bad,
Here come her grandkids. Here comes her were they great grandkids or
this great, is Evan would be a great grandkid. Yeah, Evan would be a great grandkid. Oh, you poor thing, you've been cooking all day.
I am tired.
Well, here come her grandkids and her great grandkids and her family, and they're coming over. And even if it's for an hour and it's chaotic, that's what she loved. And now here comes this Mr. Justin Schlegel, who's a part of the family now.
Hey, boys.
Who, you know, 3 years in is calling the shots and taking everyone to a restaurant.
And it's funny because everyone is on board. And they don't have the stones to tell Mimi. And then someone did in the family. And boy, oh boy, they suffered the slings and arrows. Well, Mimi ain't happy.
And here's the other thing, too. I was just thinking about your
betrayal.
There's stress, obviously, in cooking. But there's also stress in being in a restaurant with a bunch of people, including a bunch of children. And when people are cooking at home and something doesn't turn out well or isn't that great, you know, nobody really complains. Because
and you're also in a
family.
House. You're not in a restaurant. So if the kids go crazy or they want to play or they want to run around,
we've
you
already
can just
taken
do that.
That into consideration with a little contingency plan. Isn't that right? Yeah. Full on tasers.
I think what you're envisioning in your head and what you think this is going to accomplish is not, you're not going to get what you're hoping for.
This could blow up in my face.
100% it will.
And what if a dish comes out and sucks?
Well,
I mean, and then you get
that
one family member that always has to complain.
Not
they make
this
a
place.
Scene.
Can I tell you where I'm going?
Well, this is what I'm eating
Ruth's
for Thanksgiving.
Chris?
This
I'm
is
not
Thanksgiving. This is what I'm getting. I'm getting cold manicotti.
This is what we paid for.
We paid $1,900.
I'm getting cold manicotti.
I think, you know.
This is the place you pick?
You'll see how it goes. And if it doesn't go well, you may not do it next time. But I think it's worth a shot if
it is
so stressful.
I just think to you in the time that somehow a child.
I think you hate America.
Well, I'm not going to say I hate America.
No, I hate America.
Oh,
no,
God.
No, I don't hate America. I just think that if it's so stressful for him, then he should give it a shot. And if you need me to talk to Mimi, okay, I'll sit her down real
fast. I'm on Mimi's side.
Hell yeah. Okay, say you go to, over the Reardons. We're going to the Reardons.
Maybe I'm just playing devil's advocate. Go ahead.
But I'm thinking, here's some points you made that hold true. You go to the Reardons' house. You cook, you clean, you eat, you laugh. You can kind of wander around the house.
Fall asleep on the couch. That's part of it. You watch
stretch
football.
Out in the living room. Hey, I'm going to pop a
button.
You
get stuffed on turkey. You pop a button. You sit on the couch. You fall asleep watching football. What's that you smell? Oh, you smell some coffee, bro. You wake up.
Can I get a
dessert
cup,
is being prepared. You walk over. You have a cup of coffee. You eat some dessert. You go back. You watch some more football. Oh, what's that? There's a fire pit going outside.
Oh, that's
lovely. Let me grab a nice fall seasonal beer and go out and sit by the fire for a while and catch up with my uncle.
Oh.
Yeah, no thanks.
Yeah,
let
so
me go
we're
downstairs
going.
And hide in the bathroom for a little while.
Yeah.
Blow up the bathroom.
Let me
go
play
some video
crush.
Games. Let me play. Yeah, it's, I don't know.
Yeah, I see. But you sort of have mobility.
It's like our boss said yesterday in the meeting.
Noted psychopath.
You're kind of making it less memorable.
We'll see if the memories are formed after.
You can make memories there. I mean, it's the people that make the memories, right?
The conversation, the quality of food. Trust me, there's a real disparity in the family. There are some people that belong on the worst chefs in America cooking sometimes, and then there's some people in the family that should be Michelin star rated. So someone might make the most delicious spiral honey ham that I've ever tasted, and then this weird old lady whose name I can't remember brings over her weird chestnut burnt cheddar crescent roll mash. And I'm like, what is this? Why did you make 50 pounds of it? No one likes
it. Oh, my grandfather would always bring up over a thing of chestnuts and roast them on the fire.
Oh,
well, and speaks, you did this just last year. You went to a barbecue joint.
Yeah, the past few years, because sister and her 7,000 kids and her husband like to eat at this barbecue place. And this year they're coming, but I made a deal with them to. I don't like eating at the barbecue place. I like eating a Thanksgiving traditional home meal. So we're going to eat at my house. They're going to take out some of the barbecue from that place and bring it.
Oh, very
cool.
Well, you guys were talking about that in the meeting before we get to some of these calls, 410-338-1098. I should have, and I'm glad I'm doing this. I'm going to. Who knows? Maybe I'll do it every year. But you're saying there's places that you can just go and buy all the barbecue or buy the traditional meal and then bring it back, and it's like those kind of thin aluminum containers.
It's just done.
Ball it all up and chuck it. In this family that I'm with, it's either all or nothing. They either want to do this stuff. Oh, we almost had a turkey disaster a couple years when someone that had no business frying a turkey tried to fry a turkey. And there is now a grease stain on a driveway that ain't never coming up unless you splash acid on it. So let's go to the phones. 410-338-1098. Let's talk to Tim in Glen Burnie, patiently holding. Tim, good morning.
Good morning, guys. How you doing?
Happy early Thanksgiving.
Happy early Thanksgiving. So last year was the first year that my family actually went out to eat. We went to Romano's, and it was a good time. They actually offered like a Thanksgiving, you know, spread.
Right.
You know, so you could order, get all the fixings and all that. I ended up getting a chicken Chesapeake because I could put a hurting on that.
Yeah.
But I think one thing that made it nice, and Justin, you probably won't get this, was there were no kids there, so I think you may have that disadvantage if you got a bunch of little kids in a restaurant that it may kill the good vibe.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Maybe.
Go south quick.
Yeah, I mean, the two bigger kids are fine. Evan, at this point, is just a whirling dervish of energy, so we might have to tether him to the wall. Let's go to Steve in PA, checking in. Steve, I'm taking my family out to eat.
Good morning, guys.
Morning.
Morning.
Morning, Josh.
Good morning.
So my family, we're going out for, this is actually the first time we're going out to eat for Thanksgiving. And it's because my parents are actually normally have it at their house, but they're buying a house. So they're in transition of getting their new house, and they don't get it until after Thanksgiving. So basically we have no place to have Thanksgiving but go out to eat. So we're trying it. We're having it with neighbors, and you know, we figure it's going to be nice and convenient, easy, no cleanup. Like
guy, do you still think when you do this, do you still feel like you're going to make some memories from this? Because the guy's right. This is the holiday season, and especially for the young ones, you're trying to make memories. You're trying to plant good thoughts in their head of, oh, family's getting together. This is good. Did you still get that going out?
Oh, yeah. I mean, for us, it's more who you're spending it with, not really where you're spending it at.
Oh, okay. No matter where you go, there you are. Let's talk to our old friend, Ryan the Garbage Man.
Hey, guys. Good morning.
Good morning.
So where did you go?
Well, normally we would go to Golden Corral for my family, but this year it's just going to be me and a couple of friends. So what we're doing is we're having a whole bunch of like homemade Mexican food, some homemade margaritas and stuff like that.
That sounds amazing.
We're going to have some chili lime shrimp, some ground beef, and my homemade that I always like to make, Dorito crusted chicken.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
That sounds nice.
That sounds delicious.
I mean, there's not going to be any chocolate Wonderfall to dip it inside of, but still, I like the concept of the Friendsgiving. Let's talk to Chris, who sounds like he's got a pretty good time plan. Chris, what are you up to?
Hey, how you doing, Justin?
I am taking my family out to eat. What are you doing?
Well, truthfully, I'm going to have Thanksgiving alone over on my side of the house.
Oh.
I've got everything set up, though, honey ham, mashed potatoes, stuffing. But as far as I'm concerned, both you and Spiegel are right. Whatever, you know, however you fix Thanksgiving, as long as you have a good time. That's what makes a celebration, that everyone is content with their choice. And you said that your family's on board with this? And Spiegel's on board with his choice. Yes. So, as far as I'm concerned,
except for Mimi.
It's a happy Thanksgiving.
Yes. Well, wait, can I ask real
except
quick?
Except for Mimi.
Yeah, except for Mimi. Mimi's pissed and I've been cut out of the will. Let me ask, you said on your side of the house, are people going to be eating on another side?
I have an I live on like the in-law suite of the house, so therefore I can fix, I have my own kitchen, my own bedroom, just... Oh. It's kind of like its own apartment over on the side of the house.
Oh, okay. Boom. Well, good, good. Like I'm glad you're taking it in stride. That was incredibly sad. Let's go to...
He seemed very happy. Why was that sad?
He had a nervous laugh about himself. This is a good thing. This is a very, very good thing. Let's talk to Dan in PA. Dan, what say you? I'm taking my family out to eat. I'm just eschewing the whole... Take them to grandma's house, dad's house, my house. We're going to let someone else do the cooking and the cleaning.
I say go for it. Why not?
My man.
We had the traditional Thanksgiving last year in the new house we just moved into. And this year it's just going to be me and the missus. So I went to my local supermarket, got a couple of choice filet mignons, potatoes, and a veggie. And that's what we're doing. I did get a pumpkin pie, though.
Ah,
I had to have my pie.
Okay.
There you go.
All that is a vehicle for whipped cream, as far as I'm concerned. What are you doing on the egg this year, by the way? You got to be doing something with that.
No, we go over to Sandy's family's house, and everything is prepared over there. It's fantastic.
Okay. Is there going to be green bean casserole?
Of course.
Just take a scoop and take it right into the toilet. Let's go to one more here. Mike in Westminster. Mike, good morning.
Morning. How y'all doing?
Morning. Can't wait to let someone else cook for me like a fancy boy.
Hey, I think you're going to do just fine. Hey, anything in your heart is going to be good. But a catering route's a pretty good route too, you know.
Yeah, having someone else cook. You know, depending on how this goes, because I think the big question mark is how is the kid going to react in a very nice restaurant. They got a little room reserved for us. It's going to be nice. But if he's just going to be this tornado of energy, next year I might do a version of this where I just basically copy Spieg's whole bit and just let someone else do the cooking and all that, and I'll take it home and all that. But, yeah, I will report back on Friday as I'm taking my family out to eat at the Olive Garden. There are lots of ways to listen to 98 Rock every day. 97.9 FM, streaming live on 98online.com. The 98 Rock smartphone app on iPhone and Android, and on your Amazon Alexa and Google Home. Make sure to follow us on Facebook at facebook.com/98online.